You know those women in life who have that something special? The ones that light up the room when they enter? The ones that exude positive energy? You know those women in life who have a vision for the future that is exciting, compelling, and a bit beyond reach, yet you believe you can reach that place? You know those women in life who make you believe that you have that special skill set to bring that vision to reality? These are the women that I have been drawn to throughout my life, both personally and professionally. And these are the women who believe we can live in a better world. And they work with intense focus and vigor to move us toward that place. In my life, I've had the opportunity to work with women who have developed women's leadership institutes that have allowed women to find their voice, discover their strengths, and recognize the importance of sharing their light with our world. In my life, I've had the opportunity to work with women who have started national and international associations for women because they recognize the importance of finding a space and place for women to work, to plan, and to dream. In my life, I've had the opportunity to work with women who have led universities in a manner that have increased student support, academic rigor, and ultimately, student success. And they have recognized that our historically underserved student population could succeed, was a gift to our campus community, and was essential for future national leadership. I want to work with visionary women who work towards something beyond themselves on something that is important. I want to work with visionary women who don't see problems, but rather possibilities, who don't criticize, but rather create, who look through a lens of optimism and opportunity and recognize that they must play a role in creating a better, stronger, more inclusive, and beautiful world. They shine their light. They share their light. And they ignite the light within others.
Paying homage to my ancestors, strong black women who paved the way, who showed me how to reach for today. From birth is a struggle for a black woman, in this country for a black woman. Entitlements afforded those not of color, not afforded to the other. A metamorphosis from a caterpillar struggling to come out of the cocoon to become a beautiful butterfly can't happen too soon. No, I'm not your sweetie. No, I do not represent all the black people in America. And no, you may not touch my hair. Imagine. To exist in a place where bias, implicit and explicit, has no space. Where there's no discrimination for race. In the meantime, yes, I do have something of value to contribute. Yes, my voice does deserve to be heard. Yes, my experiences are important. I will not just be discouraged. I will forge ahead. Climbing the ladder of success, searching for an equitable path, blazing the trail for others to come, not getting distracted by the math. You is kind, you is smart, you is important. Get up earlier, stay longer, work harder, jump faster, run faster, think smarter. Don't get weary, never tire. You can rest when you expire. The plight of a leader in times like these. Not much has changed since we were freed. The ultimate goal is what my ancestors told. Strong black women of color paving the way, granting me the opportunity to conquer, to stay. Think what you want, Ignore me if you please. My mission is clear, it won't take its leave. Escaping the chains and tearing down the walls, no matter the cost. Breaking through that ceiling, because I'm a boss.
Las mujeres hermosas se preguntan dónde radica mi secreto. No soy linda o nacida para vestir una talla de modelo. Pero cuando empiezo a decirles, todas dicen que miento. Y digo, está en lo largo de mis brazos, el espacio de mis caderas, la cadencia de mi andar, la curva de mis labios. Soy una mujer. Fenomenalmente, mujer fenomenal. Esa soy yo. Ingreso a cualquier lugar, tan tranquila como es posible. En cuanto al hombre, los tipos se ponen de pie o caen de rodillas. Luego revoltean a mi alrededor. Una colmeja de abejas albíferas, y digo, es el fuego de mis ojos, el brillo de mis dientes, el movimiento de mi cadera, la alegría de mis pies. Soy una mujer. Fenomenalmente, mujer fenomenal. Esa soy yo. Incluso los hombres se preguntan qué ven en mí. Se esfuerzan, pero no pueden rozar el misterio de mi interior. Cuando intento mostrárselos, dicen que no logran verlo. Y digo, está en la curvatura de mi espalda, el sol de mi sonrisa, el porte de mis pechos, la gracia de mi estilo. Soy una mujer. Fenomenalmente, mujer fenomenal, esa soy yo. Ahora comprendes por qué mi cabeza no se inclina. No grito ni ando de saltos. No tengo que hablar muy alto. Cuando me ves pasar, deberías sentirte orgullosa. Y digo, está en el sonido de mis talones, las ondas de mi cabello, la palma de mi mano, la necesidad de mi cariño, porque soy una mujer. Fenomenalmente, mujer fenomenal, esa soy yo.
Never allow the fear in your mind prevent your feet from moving you forward, she said as I sat crisscross applesauce on the green shag carpet of my mother's living room. But Nana, I'm not sure I can. Of course you can. Every opportunity to succeed is also an opportunity to learn from failing. My grandmother was the living embodiment of the transformative power of higher education. She transcended place and time, shed all expectations of a woman in the early 20th century, and became the heroine of her own life story. In my childhood imagination, she was the Norwegian female version of Luke Skywalker. She survived the German occupation of her country as armed military soldiers transformed the warmth of her childhood home into a command center of war. Through circumstances I can scarcely imagine, she came to understand that it is the pressure of the unimaginable that creates the space to envision what is possible. So she imagined a more equitable future for women, where leaders would be valued for their ability to empathize and collaborate, as opposed to isolate and dominate. And so she set out to write her own story alone, in the pursuit of an education and the elusive American dream. At a time when women were rarely afforded educational opportunities anywhere, she found a way to secure one, working as a housekeeper and childcare provider, to become one of only a handful of women to obtain a master's degree in this country at that time. But she also became a mother, grandmother, friend, and mentor who paved the way for those around her. Her courage afforded me the great privilege of knowing from a very young age that I too could write my own story, as opposed to the one that others had written for me. So now it's your turn to place your feet on the path that has been forged by the women who came before. Women who paid dearly through circumstances we can scarcely imagine to never allow the fear in their minds prevent their feet from moving them forward.